Yes, there's so much to learn, so many things that we don't know. And we all learn from the Vaishnavas. So many things come to us in parampara. We can think of Mother Yamuna and how she wrote this cookbook, right? And it's not just a cookbook. Those who don't know may think, okay, another cookbook. You know, we have lots of cookbooks, and there's Yamuna's cookbooks, and it's a pretty good one. But, you know, another cookbook. No, that's not at all another cookbook. That is parampara. Because Srila Prabhupada, he was very expert. When it came to cooking, Prabhupada really was very, very expert. Prabhupada said he had learned by watching his mother. Right? And Prabhupada was an expert cook. And then he taught Yamuna how to cook, and she cooked in the Prabhupada way. So her cookbook these are the Prabhupada recipes. This is how Prabhupada cooked, right? It's not just, okay, you know, different recipes. No, these are the Prabhupada recipes. So this is a parampara right there. It's like, so we see that Guru Tattva is not only manifesting in the names that are there in the parampara. We see that from Krishna unto Srila Prabhupada, there are 32 names. Right? In the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, there's a page where these 32 names are given. Then we can, you know, have next generations of gurus, so we can add names. And in this way, we can look at a parampara. But that's not just parampara. So many things come to us in parampara, actually. Guru Tattva is there invested in many Vaishnavas, and it is the community of Vaishnavas through whom we learn. Of course, Srila Prabhupada was acting as the initiating spiritual master of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness. And once in Mayapur, Satadanya, he was in Mayapur, and he was involved in, together with Jayapataka Maharaj Bhavananda Prabhu in developing Mayapur. So he was a sannyasi. And one day, he met one of Srila Prabhupada's cup brothers who said, yes, your spiritual master, yes, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, he is your Diksha Guru, and I'm your... So then later he told Srila Prabhupada, he said, you know, I met so-and-so Maharaj, he said that I'm your, you know, your Siksha Guru, and Prabhupada's your Diksha Guru. And Prabhupada said, go back to him and tell him that I'm both your Diksha and Siksha Guru. That was very nice. So Prabhupada very much was acting as an instructor, very much acting, instructed the devotees in every aspect of spiritual life, really. Translated the essential books that basically give us a full understanding of what spiritual life is and how to practice it and so on. Then he gave many personal instructions. Prabhupada was always instructing. We're seeing that many examples again in Mayapur, walking with Bhavananda, and there was a puddle of water. So Prabhupada was elderly, so Bhavananda sort of reached out with a hand to kind of support Prabhupada as he was stepping over the puddle. Then Prabhupada was on the other side of the puddle. He turned around,
and pushed Bhavananda, like pushed him away. So he's a little shocked, pushing me away like this. Then Prabhupada said, yes, this is the Mayavadi. He takes the hand to get across the ocean of nescience, and when he's on the other side, he pushes the guru away. In this way, Prabhupada was teaching, constantly teaching. Prabhupada was an acharya, always thinking in every one of his acts. He was giving the example. He was teaching how to practice Krishna consciousness and how to act. Here in Radhadesh, our Nikunjavasini, she was there when this installation of Lord Jagannath, who are now here in Radhadesh, was happening in Amsterdam, and the ceremony was not so well organized. It was total chaos. Everything was wrong, and Prabhupada was, and there was a television station there to film everything. Unfortunately, that film has never surfaced. Anyway, Prabhupada was upset in front of TV. It was just 1 month after the Maharishi Yogi had been in Amsterdam, and here, who was all bubbly and blissful, and here was the Hare Krishna Guru, and he was angry, outright angry. Angry because Krishna wasn't properly cared for. He cared for Krishna. He didn't care for the TV and all the viewers and trying to make a good impression. He was trying to make sure that Krishna was cared for. So in this way, Prabhupada acted as a guru. Always giving preference to Krishna. Always understanding that in every situation, first Krishna. Krishna is the priority. Krishna is important. Whatever is important to Krishna is important, and nothing else is important, no matter how important it seems to be. Right. In India, when we had the opening of the Delhi temple, it was quite nice, I must say. For one thing, they cleaned the streets, believe it or not. All the streets around the Delhi temple, they were just spick and span. I didn't think it was possible, but it was. It was amazing. The streets were clean. The president, the most important, the prime minister, sorry, of India was coming to open the temple. The number one in all of India. Well, I saw black cat commandos with dogs going all over the temple, sniffing here and there, and with metal detectors, making sure everybody was safe. Then suddenly the dogs burst into my room with the black cat commandos. I was sniffed, I was scanned, I was approved, and I got the VVIP badge, which meant I could be inside. And so it all came to pass that the Prime Minister of India was there, and I remember he gave a speech, and in that speech he made the point. He says, today everyone is very excited because today is a special day. He said, because today the most important person in India is personally present. He said, namely, Lord Krishna. And that was brilliant. I mean, from the mouth of the Prime Minister of India, that was like a glorious moment, you know? That was really like where India showed its strength, right? Its real spiritual strength. It was amazing. So that was wonderful that a Prime Minister of a country understood that Krishna is the most important person in the entire country. And if other countries would simply understand this, and if India would really embrace this, that Krishna is the most important person in the whole country, what would not become of the world? then so many amazing things would start to happen. This was Srila Prabhupada's agenda. Very simple. Indrari Vyakalam Yugam. Krishna Stu Bhagavan Swayam. Just to establish that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God and to tell everyone, Yare Deke Tarika Krishna Upadesh Amaragyaya Guru Haya Tarihidesh. Tell everyone about Krishna. The famous in Chicago O'Hare Airport, and Prabhupada told Mukunda, just go to the manager of the airport and tell him to rename the airport to O Hare Krishna Airport. Ha ha ha, Prabhupada, good joke. It wasn't a joke. He was serious. He left no stone unturned. He tried every opportunity with anyone and everyone. And if there's anyone in the history of Gaudiya Vaishnavism who has proven this verse, Yare Deke Taraka Krishna Upadesh Amara Gyaya Guraya Tareidesh, then it's Srila Prabhupada. Nobody has been able to show that level of just consistently putting Krishna in the center in every situation. Now, this is really what it means to be guru. And, of course, it also means to be disciple. This is what it means to be disciple. To put Krishna in the center of our life at all times, and in all situations. Krishna first, and then everything else. All other desires, I mean, so many desires, what can we do? From the moment I guess already when we are in the womb, there are desires. And from the moment we come out, so many desires. And it's just desire after desire after desire. It never ends, never ends. I already desired many things this morning. I don't know about you, but I'm already tired from desiring. I've been desiring like anything. Sometimes we don't do much in a day, but even then we're exhausted just from all the desires, so many desires. So I spoke a bit about desires last night also. When you speak all the time, then one lecture becomes the continuation of the other one. So I spoke yesterday about desires coming forth of the lower nature and desires coming forth of the higher nature, that we are ignoring the ones springing forth of the lower nature and following a system of principles and regulated behavior to deal with that, that we can ignore because we chant Hare Krishna, and that gives us spiritual strength by which we're able to ignore the lower nature. But that we should develop and cultivate the desires springing forth of the higher nature, namely desires in relation to Krishna. I always like the Radha Gopinath temple in Jaipur, because on the side there is that outfit of Madhu Pandit, the Goswami. And Madhu Pandit Goswami was wearing a jacket and a hat made from very fine tulsi beads. And I thought, very fine. It's like a jacket. And that's what he was wearing when he was chanting japa. And I think, wow, this Madhu Pandit was not just your average, devotee. He was